Hello and welcome to a new video about contour engineering. Now we know really a lot of standard elements. Now it's time to apply those standard elements to our application. And we said our application is controlling. So we had this control loop, and I will now try to explain how we can apply this transfer functions, transfer theory, and so on, to our control loop. So I will draw the control loop. So we have somewhere a control system. This did not change. And of course, we have somewhere a controller. This did also not change. Why should it? Then we said we have to measure. So we have must be somewhere, must be a measurement. So there is actually the controlled variable as a result. This is measured. So here we have our x. This is this controlled variable. Then we have a mixing point here. Then we have a measured controlled variable. This must not exactly be the same, right? And we said this controlled variable, or this in this case, this measured controlled variable, this is somehow compared. So this is, there's one plus, there's one minus. This is compared to a desired value. To a reference variable, W. Okay, and what was the result? The result was the controller deviation. Should somewhere have a brown colored? Then it's this. This was XD, control deviation. Okay. And on the other hand, the other side, we did have control element. Okay, and this control element is influenced by the controller, and actually this control element should influence the controlled system with y. This is the correcting variable. Okay. However, we also have disturbances, we said, and we simply will try to model them here. So this is our sets here. This is the disturbance signal. Disturbance signal. This will be simply added to the correcting variable. And whatever is the result here, this will influence the control system. Okay. So this is actually how a control system looks like. We talked about this, going in circles and so on. So, to make it a little bit more easier, yeah, we will plan or think about that the control element is part of the controller, okay? And the measurement is part of the control system. Yeah? So actually, the control element, we assume it's part of the controller, and the measurement is good enough that the controlled variable and the measured control variable, they are pretty much the same, we say. Okay? So actually, it is then coming down to this, yeah? Looking like this, there is somewhere the control system. The output of the control system is now actually the measured this one, the measured controlled variable, yeah? However, we still call it controlled variable. The not measured, I don't even know, okay? So, and then here I will draw the controller now on this side. The controller's output is already the correcting variable. Yeah? So here we have y. Correcting variable. Yeah. However, the disturbances are added here. Yeah? So here are our sets, yeah? Our disturbance signals. They are added. Yeah? And then we have somewhere another mixing point, yeah? Where the input is the reference variable W, plus, and of course the other side input is the controlled variable. This is added negative, yeah? And the difference xd, the control deviation. Okay, now we simplified this, yeah? From this, including measurement and control element, to this, yeah? Now we have two parts. Yeah? And we say those two parts are transfer elements. Okay, so the controller is a transfer element which is transferring the control deviation to a correcting variable. And the control system is transferring its input, correcting variable plus disturbance signal, into the controlled variable. So those two things, I assume that those are transfer elements, yeah, with a certain transfer function. So we are ending up in two transfer elements one with a, I will call it FR for regulator transfer function, and one with a system transfer function. Okay? The output of the system transfer function is the controlled variable in picture. Yeah? This is fed back here. Minus. Here we have the reference variable, also in picture area, so W from S. Here we have the control deviation, also in picture area, XD from S. Here we do have the correcting variable as output. Y from S. Yeah. Here we're adding the disturbance signals. Z from S. Yeah. And this we will feed in into the system. Now I've substituted my reality with two transfer elements. And we can now calculate different total transfer functions from W to X, from Z to X, from and so on. We will see we can then read something out of this. This will then be done in next video. For now, it's important that you understand how we get to this and what things that the control element is inside the controller and the measurement is inside the system. That this is some sort of simplification. We simply do to make it not that complicated. Next time we're going to calculate different transfer functions to try to read out what we might, what would be ideal. Okay, and think already about if we could reach this ideal situation. For this time, thank you very much for listening. Goodbye.